We hope everyone's having a fantastic week. We're about a month and a half or so into the school year, and this is about the time that we start getting a number of questions in regards to what a chiropractic physician is able to certify when it comes to a lot of school issues. And so there are three primary areas that we're going to talk about today. We're going to talk about teacher sick leave, student sick leave, and also the modification of physical education. All three of these are questions that we get on a variety of different times throughout the school year, and also ones that seem to raise some questions with individual school districts. So we're going to start with sick leave for teachers. This one is actually pretty simple. Not all school districts require notes, but they're actually able to request a note, and very specifically in it is 105 ILCS 5/24-6. That is the site for the law that you might need if this ever comes up and somebody questions a note that you've written for a teacher. You absolutely have the authority as a chiropractic physician to sign a note for a teacher sick leave. In fact, what the statute specifically says is the school board may require a certificate from a physician licensed in Illinois to practice medicine and surgery in all of its branches, a chiropractic physician licensed under the Medical Practice Act of 1987. So that obviously includes you. So you are definitely able, under the law, to sign a teacher sick leave certificate if it's required, but again, not all school districts require. Now, another question that we get on a regular basis has to do with student sick leave and whether or not you're able to sign a student sick leave note if a student requires missing school. And so what it basically says is that a student has to attend that meets the specific qualifications, but in 105 ILCS 5/26-1, what it says is an exception to the requirement to attend school is any child who is physically or mentally unable to attend school with such disability being certified to the county or district truancy officer by a competent physician licensed in Illinois to practice medicine and surgery in all of its branches, a chiropractic physician licensed under the Medical Practice of 1987. So quite clearly, again, for student sick leave, you're able to certify sick leave in those cases. And again, you just sign the note and make sure that the child, the parents get that note so they can present it to the school appropriately. Now, the last one is one that we get actually more often than even the other two, and that has to do with modification of physical education. I don't know why this one keeps coming up. I'm not sure why we continue to have challenges in this. I'm not sure why a student would want to put a child who has some level of a challenge or is having difficulty and needing treatment under physical duress in certain circumstances. However, the law specifically does allow a chiropractic physician to modify physical education for students. In fact, that site is 105 ILCS 5/27-6. I'm going to say that one again because this one may come up in your office. It's 105 ILCS 5/27-6. And so in this case, then physical education is required except when appropriate excuses are submitted to the school by a pupil's parent or guardian or by a person licensed under the Medical Practice Act of 1987. Additionally, it says special activities in physical education shall be provided for pupils whose physical or emotional condition, as determined by a person licensed under the Medical Practice Act of 1987, prevents their participation in the courses provided for normal children. So in this case, you are licensed under the Medical Practice Act of 1987, and quite clearly under the law that we just talked about, you are able to modify a student's participation in physical education. So if you run into any of these challenges throughout the school year, you can cite them now, the law, and if you have any additional challenges that come up, please give us a call at the ICS office. We'd love to help you jump those hurdles and get that taken care of to make sure that your patients are protected, that they're able to take the appropriate amount of sick time, and most importantly, in the physical education realm, that the patient is protected from further damage, as you may indicate in your course of treatment. You have a great week, and hopefully we'll see you this weekend at the Chicago National Convention and Expo in Naperville, and we'll catch you next week in video otherwise. Take care.